Hello, my name is Rick Utzer with Airgun Web and Airgun Web TV. Since starting Airgun Web TV, I've found that I really like getting out from behind my desk and out into the field, especially when I can take my fifth wheel. Now, I've always got a crew with me, and it's either my family or it's the Airgun Web TV crew. And we've got our cell phones, our tablets, our computers. We have all kinds of electronics we need to keep charged. Now, that leaves me with a couple options. The first is to park it in an RV park, and that certainly is good. But if we're not right next to where we need to be, it does create a little bit of a logistics problem. The other option is to go ahead and bring a generator with me, and I really want to get away from that. Now, the real solution I've always wanted is to install a solar setup that's turnkey and that's fully integrated into my RV. Now, there are a ton of options out on the market, and how do you know which is going to be the right one? And moreover, how do you know that it's going to be installed and worked optimally for your needs? Well, let's see if I can make this a little bit easier. After a ton of research, I found the Solar Gurus from Windy Nation. Now, they're based out of Ventura, California, and they seem to really have a good handle on exactly what I needed for my situation. Now, while the systems are certainly able to be self-installed, I've decided to work with the folks at USA RV Marine here in Lake Havasu City. They've done all the work on my coach so far, and they've done a great job, and I know I can trust them to do this right. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the process as we install our own turnkey solar power system that should provide plenty of juice for extended off-road trips. Let's get started. Let's take a look at the various components that we're going to use for this project. Everything you see here is available directly through WindyNation.com, and their helpful support folks can help you pick a pre-packaged setup or, like in my case, design something custom tailored just for your needs. Either way you go, Windy Nation's got your back and is there to help you throughout the entire process. Let's take a look at the gear. Every solar project is going to have some key components, and today we're going to start with the panels. Now, we're using 100-watt polycrystalline panels that are designed to mount directly on your RV, boat, or even your off-grid cabin if you like. They're not too heavy or too big, so they're easy to handle and install. The polycrystalline solar cells are designed to provide maximum output even when there's not optimal light or the angle's a little bit off. These are a great solution for any solar project. Next, you have the heart of your system, which is the charge controller. Now, we're using an MPPT charge controller, which is the most advanced technology currently available. Its job is to monitor the power from the panels and to deliver it to the batteries in the most efficient and productive way, as well as prevent overcharging, which can lead to battery and other equipment failures. This particular controller costs a little bit more up front, but it's a better fit, especially if you're going to be dealing with a lot of variable conditions in the field. The next piece of the puzzle comes down to batteries. Now, there are basically two different types of mainstream batteries on the market. The first are your traditional flooded batteries. These are what you normally are going to find in your car, and they require maintenance. The other is going to be a sealed AGM battery, and that is maintenance-free. They both have their good points, and talking with the folks at Windy Nation is going to help you decide which one's going to be best for you. Seeing as these are going to go in my RV, I chose the AGM batteries because they are maintenance-free and also fume-free, so we shouldn't have any of that to deal with when we're on the road. To make use of all the energy stored in the batteries, you need to get it plugged into your RV or boat power system. If all you needed was DC power, you'd basically be done. But today's coaches leverage a lot of AC power, so you're going to need to convert that DC power to AC power via a device called an inverter. Most of Windy Nation's turnkey systems come bundled with inverters designed to match the particular system. In my case, I already have an integrated inverter built into the coach, so we can jack right into that from the batteries. Lastly, and they are some of the most critical parts of any system, are all the various mounts, connectors, wires, and the other gadgets that if you don't have them, will short circuit your install before it ever gets started. Fortunately, Windy Nation can bundle everything you need for a successful install. Just make sure you consult with them before you make your purchase so they can put together exactly what you'll need. Now it's time to start the install. If you're unfamiliar with the process, please be sure to thoroughly consult with Windy Nation's technical support staff before you start, or go ahead and talk to your local RV service center about having them professionally install the system for you. Now, after sorting and checking all of our gear, we started by mounting the solar panels. Start with a clean, dry surface and make sure to have plenty of Dicor sealant handy. Do not use hardware store silicone as it won't hold up. The last thing you want is a bunch of leaks in your RV roof. Once the panels are mounted, it's time to connect all the wires. Now, you're probably going to need a schematic and you'll probably need to make some jumpers. So please be sure to contact Windy Nation for all the details on how these need to go together. Once the panels are properly connected, you'll need to get the main wires down into the coach. The most convenient method is generally to use the refrigerator vent and then go ahead and route them to where you'll be mounting the charge controller. Be sure to fasten all the loose wires on the roof with screw fasteners and don't be bashful with the Dicor. Choose your next step and either set up your batteries or connect up the charge controller. But before you connect anything, be sure that you've thought about how and where to install the necessary fuses to prevent damage to the system and your coach. Windy Nation has a very good article located on their website to help. Please be sure to refer to this information before connecting the equipment. We've decided to go ahead and set up our 5 80 amp hour batteries. Please make sure to connect the wires correctly to maintain a 12 volt system. If you're using the larger 6 volt golf cart batteries, the wiring is going to be very different, so make sure that you've got the right plan in place. For this install, we've set up our 5 80 amp hour batteries in parallel to create a total of 400 amp hours of storage. With the batteries installed and ready to take a charge, we can move on to the charge controller and tie everything together. Now, location of the charge controller is very important. We've mounted ours near all the other electrical systems and panels. The controller mounts via a simple bracket that's mounted first, and then the charge controller simply locks into place. Let's tie it all together now. With your wires run from the roof down to the charge controller, it's time to connect the solar panels. The connection on the charge controller is clearly marked. Be sure to verify polarity before making the connection. Once secure, we can move on to connecting the system to the batteries. Again, the connections are very clearly marked, so do pay close attention to the polarity. Now it's time to go ahead and connect up the temperature sensors to the controller. You're going to have two sensors. One is going to measure the ambient temperature outside, and the second is going to measure the temperature of the batteries. The charge controller will use this information to adjust how it charges the battery bank. And lastly, connect the remote module if so equipped. Now, you're going to need to set up your charge controller for battery type, storage capacity, and also some other environmental settings. Be sure to consult the manual for the correct settings, and don't hesitate to contact Windy Nation's technical support if you have any questions. With everything connected and no error codes from the charge controller, we've got a successful install. Well, guys, this is what it's all about. You know, I had this solar system installed over at USA RV Marine. It was provided by Windy Nation. We're out here in the beautiful country. We're probably miles from anything being able to plug in. We're able to run all of our gear, have a great time. We can come out here and stay as long as we want. I was just checking the batteries. It's overcast, and right now we're almost putting 5 amps into the batteries to charge them up. We're not even in full sun yet. It's not even 9 o'clock yet. This is why I got this system. I can't tell you how happy I am, both for the guys over at USA RV Marine for installing it, and of course, Windy Nation for hooking us up with this system. If you want more information, go to their website, www.windynation.com. Of course, you can always look me up at www.airgunweb.com. My name is Rick Utzler. Thanks for watching.